magnifying that, but in St. Thomas's Church, St. Anne's on Sea, and that brings up all the stuff that we've been doing. Wade through the whole lot of it since last time was locked down. Right.
I can hear you clearly.
Good. That's always a good start. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we come to worship God, we come aware of our faults and our failures. Since we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin that holds us back, and look to Jesus in penitence and in faith. Lord, you are gracious and compassionate. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are loving to all, and your mercy is over all your creation. Christ, have mercy. Your faithful servants bless your men and speak of the glory of your kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We stand to say the glory and age of Chelsea together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
The prayer for today, the feast of all the saints. Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Christ our Lord. Grant us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtues and godly living, that we may come to those inexpressible joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Please sit for our New Testament.
A reading from the book of Revelation. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple, and the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat, for the Lamb at the centre of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. This is the word of the Lord.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and talk them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way, they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Speak in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Today, as we've heard, we celebrate the Feast of All Saints, giving thanks to the witness of saints throughout the ages for the faith they show and the light they shine in the world. I would ask you to name a saint that you consider to be something. Who would that be? Would it be one of the disciples, like Peter, who often got things wrong at first? Or Thomas, who we often think is doubt? Or one of the gospel writers like Luke? And what about the women? People like St. Hilda, who had great respect and authority, and gave it up, found monasteries, and was involved significant decisions for the Synod of Whitby, or Julian of Norwich, caught up in really difficult times, but centered on the love of God. evening, Underhill said this: "There is not, of course, any such thing as a normal kind of saint. A saint is just a human being released from the love of self and enslaved by the love of God. Any kind of human being will do for that, and the less conventional he is, the better." Conscious of our own failings, yet rejoicing in God's love and strength as we live in this world, our focus on God, rather than distractions like power, wealth, and speaking and acting where appropriate against injustice and for truth. And yet, in the words of St. David, in the little things, the kindness and service to others that's not necessarily noticed by any that are so close to God. But we don't always know where that will lead us here on earth. It is in that trust, faith, walking on our journey with God as a saint before us, that we show his life and love to others. As his faithful people have done and shown us from age
now, in place of our usual affirmation of faith or the creed, we're going to give thanks for all the saints. The response is on your sheet. Let us give thanks for the holy people and every year. For Abraham and Sarah, our ancestors, Moses there, who led the people of Israel to freedom, the promised land. For Isaiah, John the Baptist, and all the prophets who spoke your truth, no matter what the cost, let us bless the Lord and thanks be to God. For the Virgin Mary, who obeyed your call to be the mother of our Lord. For Andrew and John and the first disciples, who left everything to follow Jesus. For Mary Magdalene, Salome and Mary, who first discovered the empty tomb, and all who proclaimed the resurrection. For Thomas, and all who find it hard to believe. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. For Peter and Paul and all the apostles who first spread the message of the gospel. For Augustine and Aidan, Boniface and Patrick, and for all who carried the gospel to this and other lands. For Francis of Assisi, John Wesley, and all preachers and teachers. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. King Alfred, Edward the Confessor, and all who tried to serve, rule in a Christian way. For Benedict, Hilda, and all who give up power and wealth to serve you in Christian communities. For William Wilberforce, Florence Nightingale, Lord Shaftesbury, and all who work to make the world a better place. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For Julian of Norwich, Teresa of Avila, Gregory of Nyssa, and all who remind us of the wonders of God. For Bede, Anselm, and William Temple, and for all who study to learn more of God. For Gregory and Dunstan, George Herbert and John Keble, and for all who praise God in poetry and song. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For Stephen, Albert, for Maximilian Kolbe, Bernard de Wood, and the whole army of martyrs who faced love, death, for the love of Christ. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For all the unsung heroes of our faith, those whose names are known to God alone, for all those in our own lives who helped us on our Christian journey and brought us to this time of faith, let us pray with thankful hearts.
Glorify
our God, in whom they put their trust. Now, as we give thanks for the witness of your saints in every place and time, as we are conscious that we are part of a whole community on earth and in heaven, we pray for the worldwide church, for Christians of every tradition, that together we may work witness to your love for all humanity, shown to us in Jesus. We pray for our Diocese of Blackburn, for Bishop Julian, Bishop Gerald, Bishop Philip, and all the churches of our diocese. And we ask your blessing on our own St. Thomas's community. Pray especially for our worship committee, as we try to help people prepare for Christmas, for this strange and difficult time. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the nations of the world, for the people of Turkey and Greece affected by the earthquake, for all the victims of war, terrorism, and oppression, for the people of the USA as they elect a new president. That you'll guide us all in the ways of peace, harmony and love for one another. We pray for our own town, St. Anne's, for our friends and neighbours, and especially this week we're asked to live to pray for those who live in Baltimore Road and States Road, in all their different needs. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray at this time for all suffering from the coronavirus, for the sick, especially those in intensive care or who are close to death, for anxious families and friends, for those suffering because of isolation and loneliness, for those whose jobs or livelihoods are threatened because of the restrictions. We pray for all who are sick in mind or body, for the confused, the distressed, those who feel unloved. We bring before you all those to whom our prayers have been asked, all those on the list of our church. And we pray too, placing into your hands all the departed, especially those who will remember by name this evening. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, could I ask the wardens to come out carrying their staves? Well, I think actually I'm going to have to bring both staves because they're both at the back. Do you know where they have sticks? Ethan, Neil, any idea why they have these long sticks?
Church wardens.
The idea was that if you fell asleep in the service, you could come up behind you and poke you with a long stick. But they're really up to date now. Because if you look at them, look at the length of those are 2 meters long. So you can socially distance, they can measure out the distance. Church wardens are called to represent the people of God, to work with the leadership of the parish, ordained and lay, to be an example and encouragement to their fellow Christians, and to promote unity and peace. As you come to be admitted, I ask you to affirm your commitment to this calling, and to seek God's grace and the power of His Holy Spirit to fulfill it. Will you, as church wardens, seek to work with the bishop, the parish priest, the parochial church council, and all who exercise leadership in your parish to further the mission of God and His purposes in the world?
I will, the Lord be in my heart.
Will you undertake your task as a spiritual calling and seek, through the power of the Holy Spirit, to promote true religion, unity and peace?
I will, the Lord be in my heart.
Will you care for the fabric and property of the church as stewards under God, and to make it your responsibility to ensure its proper upkeep and repair?
I will, the Lord be in my heart.
God, give you grace to serve Him with dedication, cheerfulness and humility. May his all-powerful Spirit direct your paths throughout the coming year, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Father, we ask you bless Kath and Joy in their duties. Guide them and strengthen them. They may serve you. Amen.
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 Now, would you both make your declaration?
I do solemnly and sincerely declare that I will faithfully and diligently all the duties of the office of church warden to the best of my skill and understanding.
We thank you for being prepared to take up this office. And in the name of the Archdeacon, I admit you to be church wardens in your parishes. In the name of Christ. Amen. Church wardens, when admitted, are officers of the bishop, and they should carry out such duties as by law and custom are assigned to them. I don't think we really need to go through the whole of Canon B 1.4, which is what they're doing. Thank you both of you for being willing to take on this role again this year. I know it's not an easy one. Thank you.
They deserve it.
Thank you.
a prayer is blessed be God forever. Bless you, Lord, for all creation. Of your goodness we have this bread for, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. Blessed you, Lord God of all creation. Of your goodness we have this wine for, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God. Please stand. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It's indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now we give you thanks, most gracious God, surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses and glorified in the assembly of your saints. The glorious company of apostles praise you, the noble fellowship of prophets praise you, the white-robed army of martyrs praise you. We, your holy church, acclaim you in communion with angels and archangels and with all who serve you on earth and worship you now in heaven. We raise our voice to proclaim your glory, forever praising you and saying,
holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, the broken bread and wine now poured, may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised him. He broke the bread, gave it to them and said, take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised him, gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink, in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bring before you the bread of life, the cup of salvation. We proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
takes away the sin of the world. Bless the Lord, who called his Son.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say
the word,
and I shall be.
Father, I receive these holy things, both my hope, own health and salvation, and on behalf of all those who would receive them, who are following on. gain peace.